Look at that beautiful sunset. The sun is gonna play tricks on us tonight, so hopefully it stays up for long enough for this video. But you clicked on this because you probably have seen that viral video going around. That's a mom talking about her son getting on pantothenic acid, i.e. vitamin B5. And she got her son on this after talking to somebody like at a grocery store, I think, something like that. And the lady suggested that he just mega dose vitamin B5. Now, you might have heard of vitamin B5 before. I've heard rumors about it, but I actually haven't heard a ton of success stories or not. And I kind of just wanted to make a reaction video and talk about vitamin B5. I did a bit of research, dived into it, saw what was available, and saw if there was actually any like hard scientific evidence. So yeah, we're just gonna break that whole thing open and see what we know right now about vitamin B5. After watching this video, I think it's really cool that this mom, she kind of figured out something that really helped her son. And apparently, you know, from the video, she's saying her son cleared up his acne by taking vitamin B5 with every meal. Now that's awesome, full stop. Anytime someone can clear up their acne with some unique way, that's awesome. But I wanted to dive deeper and go into the science. And so I tried looking for scientific studies that address vitamin B5 dosing for acne and if it can actually clear up acne. And there's actually very, very little scientific research when it comes to this topic. There's only one study that I was able to find, and this study had 48 subjects. 41 of those 48 subjects were actually evaluable. So there was a significant mean reduction in total lesion count in the pantothenic acid group versus the placebo at week 12. So what that basically means is that there was an improvement with a good amount of these people that was significant enough that they thought that this showed a correlation to taking vitamin B5 and the difference in their total lesion count, which to me means the total amount of pimples that they could count on their face. So right off the bat, that's really cool. I mean, again, it's only one study, and so the study only had 48 people. You know, how correctly did they do it? You know what I mean? That's the problem with scientific studies, is that unless they're groups of like thousands or unless there's a lot of different studies, it's hard to take just one study as proof that it works, because you know those people could have also been taking, you know, a medication, or they could also change something about their diet, or because they're in this study they could have been eating healthier. There's a lot of different things that could have thrown it off, but I'm not saying that vitamin B5 doesn't work. I'm just saying we do have to take things with a grain of salt, but we're off to a good start that this may be something that, you know, is promising. Okay, so the next thing that I found was a website addressing this whole B5 acne thing, and they offered a lot of different things that vitamin B5 does, backed up by science, that aren't necessarily about acne. B5 accelerates wound healing, B5 moisturizes and improves skin barrier function, B5 is a strong anti-irritant and reduces inflammation, B5 reduces sebum in patients with oily skin. Sebum is the oil that comes out and forms into pimples. So your sebaceous glands, if they're active, are what basically create pimples on your face. So it turns down sebum production, and B5 might be antimicrobial. Now, the caveat to this is that as I was going through the site, some of the studies didn't link to anything. So you click them and then you'd actually find the link. And then when you try to open it up, it would just be like website not found. So I don't know if the studies are gone or if they weren't legit or if there just was no study in the first place. But those things are very interesting. Again, all of those things would lead to the same kind of conclusion that any of these five things also have to do with improving your acne. So I think that is also promising. Now, moving on to the last thing here is I was looking around websites again, and I found one that actually gives a protocol for moderate to severe acne. So this says that you should take pantothenic acid, which is vitamin B5, at 750 milligrams, and also take 250 milligrams of L-carnitine 3 times a day. So you take 750 pantothenic or vitamin B5, 250 L-carnitine 3 times a day. You would also take niacinamide, I can never say that word correctly, at 500 milligrams once a day. And the kind of going theory around the internet is that you would take this with a meal. Are you guys bothered by my hair? Because I'm freaking bothered by my hair. Hold on. Is this better? God. gosh, damn, that hair. Sometimes it's fun, sometimes it sucks. If you go on the internet and you look around Reddit and you look around different forums and stuff, you'll see a lot of people who say that B5 has definitely worked for them. And by basically doing what that protocol or mega dosing it, they've seen huge results. So in the past, I think in the 70s or 80s, there was a doctor who came up with this whole theory and had suggested people to take like a crazy amount, like 5 grams a day of B5. But according to a lot of these websites, there's no adverse side effects. It's not bad for you to do it. Again, I am not a medical professional. You should talk to your doctor and talk to professionals. You shouldn't just take my word for it. All I'm doing is just, I went and researched around the internet. I figured out what is available out there and what we know so far. And this is an interesting thing. It's promising in a way, but I wouldn't bet the whole farm on it. Is that a phrase? I think that's a phrase. Yeah, I wouldn't say that like when you do this, you should feel like you're for sure solving it and you're never gonna have acne again. Maybe try it and maybe see if it helps you. And if it does, you know, I'd love to hear about it in the comments below. But definitely not something that you can like reliably know it's going to solve it for you. But you know what, if you're looking at like doing something like Accutane, maybe this is a step that you do before you get onto that. Also, the great thing about this protocol is that vitamin B5 is super cheap. If you go on Amazon, it's like infinitely times cheaper than pretty much any other thing you could do, especially like skincare products and stuff like that. So yeah, I just wanted to make this video real quick, talk you all the way through it, talk about the protocols, talk about the research that's out there, and just get on through this. And apparently, while we did that, my hair had its own agenda and it just wanted to make me look stupid, and it probably looks really stupid right now. I haven't looked at it. I probably have a big pineapple head, but whatever. We're on my roof. The sun is down. This whole thing's a mess. But I love you guys. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you have anything to add to this, if you've tried this B5 thing, if you're gonna try it, whatever it is, let us know in the comments below, because we all scroll through there. This is a community. This is Team Acne, so it helps when you guys also put in your 2 cents. I appreciate that so much. Make sure you give this big thumb up and subscribe if you're not subscribed already. Remember, you are not alone. You are beautiful and you're part of Team Acne. I'll see you guys in the next video.